好，现在有声音。
他现在听到吗？
So, today is just, sorry about that, it's just a test with the Xi'an contact. So today we have this introduction about the Xi'an high-tech zones. First, Mr. Jiang will give you this introduction about the industries, about the innovations, the whole high-tech zone. And later you can have the questions for about this, about the science and technology innovation in Xi'an, and also if you would like to have some idea about cooperation, you can exchange your idea with Mr. Jiang. So next, I will pass this voice to Mr. Jiang. OK, 江总，这边已经可以，您可以开始了。这边已经给你介绍。
好。先生们、女士们，大家下午好，我是西安高新区硬科技创新局蒋仁国。今天我给大家交流一下我们的题目，就是深度融入“一带一路”共建的大格局。今天，好、哦、，OK。他翻译我们听不到。
哎，陈阳。
现在可以听到吗
？OK.
So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's really my pleasure to be here and to share with you about our experience in Xi'an High Tech Zone. My name is Jiang Wenguo. I'm from the Bureau of Hard and Core Technology Innovation Bureau. And today I would like to introduce you our experience and development in conducting a deep involvement in the Belt and Road Initiative.
OK.今天跟大家主要交流四个方面的内容。
So I would like to present in four perspectives.
第一部分就是西安高新区的简介。
So first of all, a brief introduction about the Xi'an High Tech Zone.
西安是丝绸之路的起点城市，是一带一路重要的门户和节点城市。西安高新区已经成为全市经济发展的主力军。我们西安高新区2020年的 GDP 是2410亿元人民币。
So actually, let's have a look about Xi'an, the municipality. Xi'an is the gateway of the Silk Road, and also is a very important hub for the Modern Belt and Road Initiative. In the meanwhile,Xi'an High Tech Zone has become a major economic contributor to the whole development of the municipality. And also, you can have a look at the slides, the industrial value added. And the 2020 GDP from the industrial zone, from the High Tech Zone, was up to 241 billion RMB.
Yes, 我们西安高新区主要有电子信息、高端装备、生物医药、汽车产业和现代服务业四大主导产业，再加服务业。另外，西安高新区的这个进出口额去年是2764.7亿元人民币。
So let's have another look about the major sectors or industries here. And Xi'an High Tech Zone highlighted ICT and also advanced manufacturing, biomedicine.Automobile and service industries, with a total value for import and export in 2020 of 276.47 billion RMB.
Yes, yes. 今天的西安高新区依托雄厚的产业基础，吸引了海量的企业。目前我们拥有的世界500强企业是115家，拥有的外资企业有超过了2000家。另外就是还有这个我们中国认定的国家高新技术企业2513家，从91年开始成立到现在，我们累计注册的企业已经超过了16万家。
So let's have another look about this slide that shows that with the strong resource and support from all sectors and from all part of the of the society. Xi'an High Tech Zone has built a strong industry foundation that attracts thousands of tenants and companies or partners. For example, we have successfully invited Fortune 500 and multinational companies with a total number of 115. And foreign companies in the high tech zone is up to 2,000 or even more. And high tech companies in the high tech zone is up to 2,513. And starting from the year 1991, that is the year of the establishment of the high tech zone, to now, there are over 160,000 companies registered in our high tech zone.
Okay. Yeah. 第二部分主要和大家交流一下，我们西安怎么带我们的产业辐射怎么带动区域经济的发展。
Next, I would like to introduce about the industry radiation that drives regional development.
Yes. 我们已经形成了高端的特色的现代产业体系，西安高新区目前已经形成了硬科技、动能产业加战略支撑产业加生活服务业的产业体系。 2020年高新技术产业的增加值增速达到了 20%， 战略性新兴产业增加值增速达到了 16%。 目前我们现在有一个世界级的产业，就是电子信息， 3个千亿级的优势产业，高端装备、汽车和生物医药，还有4大硬科技产业，就是人工智能、大数据、云计算、增材制造和基础新材料。
So here is another look about the modern industries and all these clusters ecosystems formulated here in the high tech zone in Xi'an. So with so many years of experience accumulation and resource accumulation, we have accumulated so many high-tech industries and strategic new industries here. You can have a look about the value-added increase from these different industries. From high-tech industries, 20%, and from strategic new industries, 16%. And this is the pyramid of the high-end modern industries in Xi'an high-tech zone, including hardcore technology industry, strategic supporting industry, and service industries. So today I would like to focus on the hot and core technology industries, which include further three subtypes: world-class industry cluster, for example, chips and smart terminals, and pillar industry clusters, for example, electricity equipment, new energy, and medical devices, and also for new tech clusters, for example, like chemical medicine, additive manufacturing, artificial intelligence, and etc.
另外, 高新区还有五个支撑性的这个战略产业，包括我们的现代金融、现代物流、研发设计、简易检测和商务服务。
And meanwhile, okay, we have another, 还是上一页。 In the meanwhile, we have formulated another five supporting sectors, including financial instruments, human capital, commercial related activities, R&D, and logistics.
Yes. 还有我们的生活服务业也很发达, 比如现代商贸、文化旅游和都市农业。
And in the meanwhile, we have very comprehensive and sophisticated services to support the people's living or life here, including some infrastructures and facilities for transaction for trading, for culture and traveling, and also we have a great foundation from the urban agriculture industry.
电子信息产业的话, 我们已经形成了半导体、软件和信息服务业、智能终端、下一代人工智能为一体的，我们叫新软端网产业体系。上一页，下一页，OK，next page，yes，这一页，新软端网。 2020年电子信息产业规模超过了2700亿元，成为中西部地区最重要的电子信息产业基地。
So here I would like to highlight the ICT industry. So we have formulated a cluster composed of very strong the strength from different fields. For example, semiconductor, software and service, smart terminals, next generation information technology or network. In the year 2020, the total revenue from the ICT industry reached 270 billion RMB. And you can have a look about these different subtypes and also all these companies and examples from different subtypes like chips, softwares, terminals, and network.
Yes. 比如说芯片领域，我们现在有三星、美光、科瑞斯、紫光国芯、易思伟等大型企业。软件方面有华为、华勤、中软国际、科大讯飞、一点天下、美林数据等等一些新兴产业。另外在智能终端方面，我们中国的中兴手机和比亚迪电子，智能手机的产能已经突破了一亿部。另外就是在网络方面，我们的华为、中兴、烽火通信和天河防务等等已经成为我们构建下一代网络的核心企业。
So actually, let's have a very close look about all these all the examples, all these enterprises from different sectors or from different segments. For chips, we have accumulated many large-scale enterprises. You can have a look from the slides, like Samsung, Micron, UNIC, ISONE, and etc. And our software perspective, we have accumulated a group of emerging companies or enterprises, including Huawei, Huaxin, and China Soft, Intel, iFlight Tech, Yemobi, Meridata. And for terminals or smart terminals, I would like to highlight ZTC, BYD here. And also the smartphone is very, is another highlight here. The annual production is up to 100 million pieces. So for a network perspective, we are fully prepared to contribute ourselves to the next generation network building because we have attracted many renowned players in that perspective. For example, Huawei, ZTC, and FiberHome.
Yes. Next page.
下一页。
对。也是汽车产业方面，我们2020年西安高新区汽车产业规模已经达到了800亿元，汽车产能即将突破65万辆，聚集各类的整车与配套企业将近150家。比亚迪、法斯特两大龙头支柱企业效用明显，三星 SDI、联合汽车、特锐德、新派电子等配套企业作用显著。就是我们坚持新能源为主的汽车发展方向，打造全国领先的新能源汽车产业基地。
So in automobile perspective, in 2020, I would like to show you our results. In 2020, this industry reached 80 billion RMB in terms of revenue with a total production of over 650,000 units. And we have successfully attracted OEMs and vehicle component manufacturers of altogether 150. So, and the leading companies here, OEMs like BYD, and which you might heard of, and also some supporting manufacturers, for example, UAS, Bosch, and TJ Good. And also for the automobile industry, our future will be like to cultivate a leading demonstration area for the new energy vehicles.
第三个方面就是我们的高端装备产业。2020年，西安高新区的高端装备产业规模达到了600亿元，产业门类齐全，主要集中在能源、动力、高端电力、航空航天、智能制造和通用专用装备等领域。高端装备的龙头企业聚集包括了散谷、西电、中石油测井、中煤科工、施耐德、特变电工、聚光科技等等一系列的龙头企业。
So, have another look about the high-end equipment industry or advanced equipment industry. Also, the performance in 2020 was very excellent. with a total revenue of the year up to 60 billion RMB and covers a complete range of fields or different strength from of different sectors. So focusing on energy power, electricity, aviation and aerospace, smart manufacturing, general and special equipment. In the meanwhile, we have accumulated a group of leading companies in this industry of advanced equipment, for example, like Shangu and Xidian, SNPC Logging, CC Tech, and Jingdiao, and Schneider, and TBEA, and Focuslight.
Okay, next. Well, 生物医药产业也是我们的四大主导产业之一。 2020年, 西安高新区的生物医药产业规模达到了300亿元, 现有的这个生物医药研发企业有810家, 包括2家医药工业的百强企业和6家上市企业。 目前这个行业龙头企业有西安阳森、闪耀集团、立邦、幸福制药、创新药的有新通药物、医疗器械的有聚酯生物、迈瑞医疗等等，已经形成了创新药的研发加医药制造加医疗流通加医疗服务业的产业链的格局。
So another pillar industry of the high tech zone, I've introduced you already on the first three, and the last one will be biomedicine industry. Also, the revenue in 2020 was up to 30 billion RMB. And in the high-tech zone, we have attracted 810 R&D bodies in biomedicine industry, and including two top 160 listed companies. And give you several examples, for example, like the leading pharmaceutical companies like Xi'an Yangsen and Shanyao Group, Libang and Xingfu Pharmaceuticals. And the companies focusing on innovative drugs include United Imaging. And also we have some players in medical devices and production, including Giant, Beijing and Mandry. So currently speaking, I should say that in Xi'an High Tech Zone, we have accumulated an industry chain of new drug R&D, plus production, plus medicine logistics, and plus medical services.
第五个方面就是我们的现代服务业。西安高新区现有320多家生产性的服务业企业，2020年的营业收入接近 1300亿, 聚集的技术转移、检疫检测认证、知识产权、科技咨询等科技服务机构，打造政产学研用经济财十位一体的创新创业生态综合体。
So another look about the modern service industry, which is a supportive industry for the high tech zone. And there are altogether 320 producer services companies, and with a total revenue in 2020 up to 130 billion RMB. And by far, Xi'an High Tech Zone has created an ecosystem composed by technology transfer, inspection, IP consultancy, and related services, science and technology services. So we have created, you can see on the slides, a well-off ecosystem or supportive platform for the development of high-tech industries.
Yes, 我们的就是西安很有特色，就是创建了我们西安科技大市场，统筹集成超过700家的科技服务机构，超过7000家的企业和科技成果。
So actually, one of the highlights for modern service industry in Xi'an High Tech Zone is the creation of Xi'an Technology Market, a technology transfer accelerator that attracts 700 technology service providers and also incubates over 7,000 companies and science and technology projects. So we can see the Xi'an Tech Technology Market is a very successful and effective technology transfer accelerator that has an impact in the country.
另外还就是我们的硬科技产业，就是硬科技的新兴产业，在硬科技新兴产业发展良好，特别是在人工智能、真材制造、大数据、云计算、新能源、新材料等领域和培育和招引了一批这种科技型的高成长的企业，比如说我们现在的伯利特、新窑、陶瓷、奇星光电等等一批在 全球具有领先的这种水平的企业，解决了 一批这种我们国家中国的一关键核心技术。 OK,
so actually let's have another look about the hard and the core technology industries in Xi'an high tech zone. So we're focusing on the AI, artificial intelligence, additive manufacturing,big data, cloud computing, new energy, and new material, these different sectors from the emerging, from the emerging technologies. And we have attracted and incubated many high growth technology companies, including BLT, GMCC, QXP, and Focus Light, etc. And they become the leading position, they are taking the leading position.In achieving breakthrough in core technology R&D.
Okay, 和大家介绍了第三个方面的内容，就是我们西安高新区的这个发展策略，就是硬科技创新引领全国的发展。
So next, I would like to introduce you about the hardcore technology demonstration zone and to exhibit or to introduce you how the hard and core technology become a driver for the national development.
我们主要从以下几个方面，第一个就是打造创新大品牌，建设中国首个国家级硬科技创新示范区，扩大西安高新区的影响力，形成吸引战略性新兴产业落地的重要品牌效应。这个国家级的硬科技创新示范区主要是通过一二三四八九的发展战略来推进。一就是一条主线，就是支持硬科技研发，畅通硬科技转化，培育硬科技企业，做强硬科技产业。 OK, 后面我再说。
Okay, so in this perspective, let's have a look about the demonstration zone. It is the first ever demonstration zone in China focusing on hard and core technology. And we created an atmosphere in Xi'an high tech zone and to make sure we have a strong hard and core technology industry that can influence or have impact in the national perspective. And nowadays, the hardcore technology demonstration zone has become a major brand to attract new emerging industries to settle down here in local Xi'an high tech zone. So for this platform of the demonstration zone, we have conducted a strategy called 1234 89. For one, that is one role, that is one major like strategy. So we encourage R&D activities and also embrace technology transfer and related activities, incubate new companies and new business and projects here, and to finally formulate major companies and to build industry clusters.
Yes. 另外就是我们的二，就是我们实现了产业链和创新链的融合，三代技术转化就实现了我们叫转化一代、研发一代和攻坚一代。另外四大硬科技产业集群就是我们的电子信息、先进制造、生物医药和我们的航空航天。另外我们正在实施八大强链行动，主要是包含了第三代半导体、光子技术与产业、 5G 和云计算、航空航天、北斗导航、特高压、数控机床和精准医疗的八大产业领域的强烈行动。九大重点任务主要是我们打造创新生态方面。 OK,
so I would like to introduce you the other the concept behind the other several figures. Tu actually means to chain. We have integrated the industry chain and innovation chain. The three actually means the third generation technology transfer. So focusing on new and emerging technologies. And four clusters, as you can see, is on the screen, is for example, like semiconductor, like biomedicine, aerospace, and astronautics. And also another one is the navigation. And the eight measures. The eight measures is strongly supported here in Xi'an High Tech Zone. We're focusing on the third generation semiconductor, like a photonic, the fifth generation of the telecommunication technology, cloud computing, aviation, aerospace, and et cetera. You can read from the slide actually. And nine missions here is all in all, the spirit of this nine mission is to create the ecosystem for innovation in Xi'an High Tech Zone.
Okay. 第二个方面就是率先形成了创业孵化的西安模式，构建了全链条的创新创业的孵化体系。西安高新区已经形成了众创空间加孵化器加速器产业园区多层次多形态多业态的创新创业载体链条。目前我们的各类双创载体有164家，孵化总面积达到了超过了900万平方，国家级的孵化器有14家，相继获批国家双创特色载体园区和国家双创示范基地。
So next is about the unique incubation model in Xi'an High Tech Zone. So we have developed our unique incubation and startup model.With a complete chain from co-working space to incubator, accelerator, and industrial parks. So, and also you can see in Xi'an High Tech Zone, there are many players conducting active incubation services. We have 164 incubation bases with a total incubation area of 9 million square meters. And also we have 14 national incubators and the Xi'an High Tech Zone has been granted by the related authorities as the National Incubation and Innovation Park and National Incubation and Innovation Demonstration Zone.
第三个方面就是创新创业人才加速聚集，高新实时效应日渐凸显。高起点，我们实施了五招聚财的方式。成为面向全球吸引和培育全球顶尖人才、产业领军人才、高端专业技术人才的重要合集。目前我们的创新人才方面，万人专家占到全省的80%，位列省市第一。企业从业人员中，海外留学归国人员和外籍常驻员工的比例位居全国高新区的第四位。另外，我们的本科学历以上的人数占到了62.7%，硕士、博士从业人员占比占到了15.72%，位列中国高新区的第一位。企业研发人员数量年平均增长26%，企业研发人员折合当量位列国家高新区的第四位。OK，
so talent perspective。Xi'an High Tech Zone also accumulated a large number of talents. For example, international talents and domestic talents, industry talents and R&D talent or technical talents. So we are working really actively to attract top talents, industry leading talents and professional technical talents from different parts of the world. Several highlights here I would like to share with you. For innovative talents, the number of the recognized top technology innovative talents take 80% of the Shanxi province total. So that is number one. So the high tech zone is number one, both in the country, in the province and in the city for the number of recognized top technology innovation talents. So for the other perspective of overseas talents, the number of overseas retainees and foreign employees ranked number four among all these national high-tech zones. For employee quality perspective, let's have a look about the educational background of the employees. 62.7% of the employees in the high-tech zone have a bachelor degree diploma, and 26% has a 26%, so that is number one, actually number one among the national high-tech zone. So for R&D personnels, the annual increase is up to 26%. The full-time R&D personnel rank number four among all the national high-tech zones.
第五个方面就是这个积极营造活力创新范围，打造全国最优的营商环境。 国际化，还有这个积极第四个方面，第四个方面是积极融入全球的创新链开展创新国际合作平台的建设。目前我们西安高新区已经建了17个海外的这个离岸创新中心、海外科技服务站和海外研发中心，探索区内注册、海外孵化、全球经营的离岸基地创新模式。目前我们的离岸中心在德国、瑞典。 北美、英国还有北美还有硅谷、澳大利亚、以色列和日本，科技服务站在这个中亚有中亚、非洲、英国和南非科技服务站。另外就是企业在海外设的研发中心有洛杉矶、多特蒙德、阿姆斯特丹、休斯敦和布兰诺研发中心。
For this slide, you can see it's the international innovation cooperation between the Xi'an High-Tech Zone and its global partners. So actually in Xi'an High-Tech Zone, we are promoting this kind of innovation from a global perspective and to create partnership with the global innovation practitioners. So we are actively creating new innovation platforms. By far, 17 overseas innovation platform has been created. The platforms can be either an innovation center or a technology service station or an R&D center. So, and also we are exploring a very new model called offshore model for innovation. That compose local registration plus overseas incubation and plus global operation. So give you several examples about the innovation partnership we have created in a global perspective. For innovation centers, we have built centers in Germany, Sweden, the United States, for example, New York and Silicon Valley, and the United Kingdom, Australia, Israel, and Japan. And technology service stations perspective, we have the stations set up in Mid-Asia, Africa, and the United Kingdom, and South America. And R&D centers has been created in Los Angeles, Dortmund, Amsterdam, Houston, and Brno.
第五个方面就是我们积极营造活力的创新氛围，打造全国最优的营商环境。目前我们有全球硬科技大会、全球创投峰会、全球程序员节等等一系列的会议。So
actually we are also working actively in creating a local atmosphere for innovation that is friendly to innovation. We are proud to say that Xi'an High-Tech Zone has the best innovation and business environment. And for all these kind of platforms or gatherings, I will like to share with you several. For example, Global Innovation Summit and a perfect innovation environment for that. And also the Global Investment, the Global Hard and Core Technology Summit and Cybersecurity Conferences.
我们营造就是最好的营商环境，主要是体现在四个方面：审批项目最少，收费标准最低，上演。 收费标准最低，办事效率最快，服务水平最优。另外还有我们的创新的审批制度，上一页，对，还后面的内容。另外就是我们的一些审批制度，创新的审批制度，全程的电子化登记，工程项目类的审批项目75个工作日办结，工商准入的注册压缩至两个工作日。 OK。
Okay, so still on these slides, let's have another look about the practices measures we have done to formulate such an excellent business environment for innovation. So we have four major measures, or you know, you can say these are four indicators or metrics to encourage business and innovation. We provide the minimum approval time or approval cost, and that is like both labor time and financial cost, and minimum cost that is from the financial perspective, and maximum efficiency and maximum services, that is the best services you can have. And from another perspective, I can see that we have reformed the approval process and to create a brand new effective and efficient approval process. And we move everything online. The registration can be done online. And also you can have the approval construction project within 75 working days. And that is highly efficient. And for 2 working days for business registration.
OK， 下面跟大家交流第四个方面的内容，就是深入推进4个国际化。西安高新区将以更加开放的姿态深入融入一带一路的建设。
Then let's move to the fourth part of my presentation is global development. We are deeply involved in the global development and the collaboration, and especially in the Belt and Road Initiative.
我们的四个国际化分别是国际化，打造国际化的通道，建设国际化的平台，构建国际化的市场，实施国际化的治理。 OK。
So these four major global practices are create global access, build global platform that can be shared by all, and to cultivate global markets,and then to conduct global management.
在国际化通道方面，第二部分，国际化通道方面就是我们建设互联互通的物流和信息通道，渐次放大国际要素的传输空间，抢占对外开放的发展先机，打通国际化的货运通道。我们是依托中欧班列和咸阳国际机场，共筑国际的物流通道优势，打造数字大通道方面，我们是推进国际互联网数据专用通道的建设，加强通信业对外向型企业的服务支撑作用，引进互联网银行、物流等知名企业在的全国性或者区域性的数据中心，争取国家的超算中心、国家级新型互联网交换中心等重大信息基础设施落户。
So in terms of global access, you can see it's both physical logistics and internet logistics. And we're trying to build a global logistics and information access. So freight perspective, we are promoting the connection or connectivity with the international partners or communities, and trying to take advantage of the global resources to support the local Xi'an high-tech zone development. And for example, you can see, and also we are utilizing all the support and resources to promote the export-oriented industry. And the major programs or the major programs here to support us, the traditional transportation, like China Railway Express that connects Xi'an high-tech zone with the European continent. And also have the Xi'an Xianyang Airport, and it's an international airport that have flight access in a global perspective. And internet or information perspective also have very convenient access and connectivity. And so we are trying to build the International Internet Data Express Center or hub here in Xi'an high-tech zone and to build internet banks or digital banks and the national regional data center, supercomputing center, and internet exchange center, all these type of infrastructures to support the internet connectivity of Xi'an high-tech zone with the external environment or with the external communities.
OK, 第二个方面就是国际，第三个方面就是国际化平台，充分发挥我们中国的自贸区制度优势，紧抓一带一路建设机遇，推进各类国际化平台建设。另外就是我们推动这种自贸区和自创区的联动，探索建立服务一带一路的国际水平的国际自由贸易港，深化本地与一带一路沿线国家的互融互通，深入落实外商投资准入前国民待遇加负面清单的管理制度，构建与负面管理清单管理方式相适应的事中事后监管制度，打造最优的自贸实验区。另外一个就是把握一带一路的建设机遇，加强一带一路的国际创新合作，建设丝路科技创新驿站联盟，推进一带一路沿线国家地区共建国际技术转移中心，构建一带一路技术转移网络。另外就是推进在欧美日韩等创新创业高地布局离岸创新中心与研发中心，在一带一路沿线国家布局海外科技服务站，在吉尔吉斯斯坦、捷克、哈萨克斯坦等等国家一带一路国家建设一批国别园区。
And also, you can see on the slides, we are actively promoting the global platform building. And from the commercial perspective, the global free trade zone or free trade free trade experimental zone. So we utilize the strength of the free trade zone and to tap the potential and to serve the bottom road market and to serve the interaction with the Belt and Road countries and regions. And also we have enhanced our investment in connectivity and interaction and infrastructure building or policy making. For example, provide national treatment for foreign investors and also have this kind of a negative list management system to the foreign investors. And in this, I believe that in the free trade zone experimental zone in Xi'an, we have the best services and environment for all this foreign investment. And from the other perspective, of the technology or collaboration with the global partners. As I introduced you already, we set up 17 platforms, including innovation centers, R&D centers, and technology service stations in different countries. So for R&D centers, we will focusing on the collaboration with the United States, Europe, and Japan and Korea that has a strong power in R&D and innovation. And for the technology service, for technology service stations or innovation centers, we are now currently working with Czech Republic and the other neighboring countries of China to from East Europe and to just to build the technology service centers over there.
第四个方面就是我们来共建国际化的市场，主要是两个方面，就是加快西安高新区的服务贸易数字化进程，高水平开放扩容园区国际朋友圈，带动国际市场的更加多元化。在服务贸易方面，我们要减少制约要素流动的边境上和边境后的壁垒，建立健全跨境服务贸易负面清单管理制度，推进服务贸易创新发展试点开放平台的建设。这个是另外一个，就是争创特色服务出口基地，发展服务贸易新模式新业态。 另外就在跨境电商方面，我们是推进跨境电商 B2B 出口监管试点，建设配套通关便利化的措施，建设丝路跨境小镇出海产业园、中保区保税仓库、二期等等跨境电商载体，建设跨境电商出海港，引进跨境电商配套服务企业，打造跨境电商的综合实验区、示范区。OK。
So, to further service the import and export, business in Xi'an High Tech Zone, we utilize the digital services and emerging technologies to create an online platform, to serve the trade and transaction activities, to expand our global market and global partners and footprints, and also to, as mentioned, to extend our global market to move it to a higher scale. And from service trade perspective, we're trying to break down all the barriers and the obstacles from the traditional system and to simplify the cross-border process. And as mentioned again, we have this negative list strategy and build service trade innovation pilot zone to serve all the foreign investments and to make sure to have the online platform for service trade. And in the meanwhile, we provide featured or characteristic services to different partners and to build service export base to develop new models of service trade. For e-commerce platform perspective, we are really moving forward in the cross-border e-commerce activities. For example, several of our endeavors including building an experimental zone for business-to-business export to simplify the customer clearance procedures. And second is to build e-commerce platform like Silk Road Trade Town, an export industrial park or free trade zone or bonded area, and also to bring in supporting services service provider to build a pilot zone for cross-border e-commerce. And then also to build an overseas marketing system based on overseas warehouse platform, et cetera.
Yes, 最后一个部分就是实施国际化治理，以加快推进组织机制改革为契机，全面提升园区的治理能力和治理水平，把握高水平的开放机遇，主要包括三个方面。第一个就是打造国际一流的营商环境，对标世界银行营商环境评价指标，建立健全企业项目全生命周期的服务体系，打造市场化、法治化和国际化的一流营商环境。另外就是完善风险防控的预警体系，健全走出去的保障体系建设，完善风险监测预警机制和信息通报制度。第三个方面就是建设综合的示范街区，深入挖掘民族文化，探索以国际化为核心，共融多种文化要素，将嘉惠法建设成为开放包容与城市创新相结合的综合性的示范街区。 OK。
So in global management or in global governance, we are trying to take all these opportunities and conduct a reform and upgrading of the current management system and to improve our governance level or service level. And that can be further breakdown into three perspectives. The first one is business environment, second risk system, risk management and control, and innovation block. Business environment perspective, as mentioned, we are building a full life cycle service system based on the Business Environment Evaluation Index by the World Bank, and also provide online and digital services to maximize the efficiency to investors or entrepreneurs. And also we have this kind of service-oriented routine management and trying to monitor ourselves in terms of service providing. So risk system in that perspective, so we have improved the risk control and alarm system to make sure and the to make sure an environment with high security, and also improve the routine management and emergency plan measures, and to enhance our capability in risk management. For innovation block perspective, we're building a harmonious ecosystem that is, as I mentioned, harmonious harmony and connectivity, tolerance and innovation are the highlights. So this innovation block with both local culture and international features that is very inclusive. And present an innovative environment by organizing different type of events and gatherings.
Okay, 我今天的介绍就到这里结束，谢谢大家。
So that is the end.
下面如果有什么问题，我们可以交流。
So this is the end of my presentation. I'm looking forward to your questions.
Okay, guys, before you raise your question, you can make a quick self-introduction about yourself. 蒋军就是他们问问题之前，我请他们先向您做个自我介绍。
Okay.
Okay, please, first the question, please.
Thank you very much for your presentation. My name is Ali. I'm from Innovation Agency Azerbaijan. We have lots of program, and we try to develop our ecosystem to the high-tech ecosystem as well. I think there are lots of the common point that maybe we can have get support from the high-tech park, like your high-tech park. What's your suggestion for the making agreement, finding best place for the cooperation with another park or countries? What's your plan?
OK，那么我先来翻译一下这个问题啊。对，我们这个问题是来自阿塞拜疆的一位学员提出的。那么刚才您在介绍中也是着重介绍了我们要打造这种创新的生态以及高科技园区的这样的一个生态建设和系统。 那么实际上在阿塞拜疆我们也展开了同样的一种工作和举措，来去希望培育我们当地的高科技或者是这个高新园区的这种生态。但是实际上我们看到就是如何进行相关的一些系统，比如说这种系统搭建的一些支持。那么与此同时也提到了进行国际上的合作，来去找到匹配不同的国际资源，来去
打造不同的平台设施。那么由您来看的话，那么对在做这种选择或匹配的过程中，一些最佳的实践或者是一些这个经验的分享。我刚刚讲的就是我们搭建国际化平台，就是我们西安高新区通过一种政策的引导，鼓励就是我们这种全国的服务机构， 在他们有这种优势资源的区域来配合我们引进一些项目，就这样的话，就是我们可以跟全球的这种创新的资源都可以连接起来。OK.
So actually, in terms of the international platform or collaboration, we have strong support and from the government, especially particularly from the administrative management committee of the high tech zone of Xi'an High Tech Zone. We're trying to build a national network to borrow the advantages and resources from the other institutions from within the country. From China, and to attract, potential foreign projects, and to settle down in our high tech zone, and to create this kind of atmosphere for international platform for international collaboration.
另外，就是我们西安经过西安高新区经过30年的发展，我们有一整套服务企业创新的 措施和政策，这一整套措施和政策为企业的发展提供了很重要的一个支撑。OK.
In the meanwhile, for the past 30 years experience, we have created a complete set of services and policies to serve enterprises in innovation.
Okay.
My main question was that regarding that, is there any possibility that the high-tech park cooperating with our parks for developing this type of the business at Azerbaijan or not?
那么它其实的想，它其实那个问题问的比较含蓄。刚才它其实这个点出来这个问题，就是说，因为我们在探索不同的这个区域，比如说像这种这个创新资源比较密集的，像这种欧美国家、主流国家，我们会合建这种研发中心呢，包括其他的一些区域，我们会建一些，比如说服务站点之类的这样的一些，就是不同层次的这样的一些平台。那么实际上，它刚才这个问题就是说，针对于阿塞拜疆来说，因为他们也想打造这种高科技的一些生态。那么实际上就是有没有机会来去跟他们共建一些哪种层次的这种平台或者是合作机制？
可以，我们下面可以，我们下面可以来私下交流，就是我可以他们提出一些具体的诉求，通过我们这边，我们可以给他们一个很好的回应，没问题。
So definitely welcome, we are open to all discussions about a collaboration or a jointly built platform in your country, and we can discuss more in detail after the session. Yes, send us more of your profile and or more of your request, and we can have analysis and in-depth discussion on that. Okay,
that's great. I'll be in touch with you, Sam.
就是与您保持联系。
Okay, 没问题，非常感谢。下面因为时间问题，其他问题我们可以通过邮箱或什么问题来。 还有是吧 ？OK.
So, do we have other questions?
Okay,
yes.
Guys. You have any other questions? Just maybe one question is bad. It's okay.
Okay. From Romania, may I have a question?
Yes, please.
Okay, I want to continue the question of the colleague from Azerbaijan regarding the condition and the possibility to have cooperation with your scientific platform. Do you have any official, let's say, frames for condition to apply? First of all, to understand exactly how we have to be prepared to come into contact with you and to build a cooperation program together. So simple, if you have a frame of cooperation condition to know if we are able to approach them, and after that, of course, to start concrete discussions with you. Some official, some, I don't know how to say, but anyhow, where we can find such information about your cooperation technical part. Thank you.
那么这个问题也是关于咱们国际合作，也是接着上面阿塞拜疆这位老师提出的问题。这位我们这位提问者是来自罗马尼亚，那他的这个问题也是关于国际合作，那么也是非常感兴趣与我们的这个西安园区来去进行这种联合共建一些这个不同的基础或者是一些这样的一些合作平台。那么其实就是提到了这个。 平台的一些申请的条件，或者是因为我们讲到了针对不同资源，或者是不同程度的一些创新的，针对于不同的创新能力来去匹配不同的这样的一个平台的搭建的话，那么想问一下有没有一些具体的文件，或者是相关的一些说明，一些这个信息来供我们参考，我们去了解，展开这个与西安高新区展开合作的一些具体的标准是什么？那么这样的话，我们也可以就是有的放矢了来去做一些准备，前期的一些材料的准备等等，来去加速，就是来。 带着这些材料或者带着这些信息来去跟我们高新区进行第一步的这个接洽，然后后面再进行更加详实更加深入的这样的一个更加高效的一个沟通。所以说就是想问一下有没有一些公开渠道的一些文件或者是我们发的这样的一些政策啊等等可以供他们参考。
可以，没问题，下来我们可以把我的联系方式给他们，然后我通过邮件把我们在这里的一些文件可以传给他们，我们一起来沟通共同推进。
So, thank you very much for your question and for your approach about your interest in this collaboration. I will leave my contact to the moderator and share with all of you. And if you have any other questions, you can just approach me. And also, all these documents and information that was sent to you through email.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, guys, I think it's time for the first session, and I'll ask Mr. Jiang to leave his business card here. So next, before Mr. Jiang leaves us, so we can have a group photo with him. So this is the session one, and then we have a break and to the next session. So please all open up your video. We have a group photo with Mr. Jiang. Jiang Jun, 你好。我刚才跟大家说了一下，就是今天就是您这边的分享就先告一段落，然后后面他们会用邮件跟您联系，然后现在我请大家把这个摄像头都打开，然后我们一起来合个照，然后我这边来截屏，通过截屏来完成这个合照。就一大概一分钟，他们现在是在都打开屏幕。So guys, please all open up your video.
Okay.
Okay. 蒋局，我们这个交这个图已经交好，然后交给您可以。跟大家就是告个别。
好 ，Thank you.
Okay, I stand. Yeah, I stand to Mr. Jiang and I'll say goodbye to him.
Thank you very much.
Okay, this is the first one, and then we have about 5 to 5 minutes break, and then we come back for another high tech zone. It's the Chengdu high tech zone, the southwest part, in Sichuan province.So I'll see you in five minutes later. Wei, Chengdu, Chen Chu, Chen Chu, 你好。
你好，你好，能听到吗？
哎，能听到。
嗯，
辛苦您，陈叔。然后现在是他们我们西安的刚刚分享完，然后现在是有一个休息，大概两三分钟以后我们会开始。然后一会儿首先的话，我先做一个简单的开场白，就是把您简单向这些学员介绍一下，然后时间交给您来分享。然后翻译的话就是一会儿您说几句，然后我们这边那个翻译老师他会翻译几句，然后顺带他会翻这个 PPT。那个陈阳老师，你现在跟陈处打个招呼吧。
OK。喂，
你跟陈叔说一下。哎，能听到。你跟陈叔说一下吧。
陈叔你好。
陈老师你好。你好，可以听到。
好呀。啊，然后就您这边看节奏来就可以。啊，我这边帮您翻译。啊，
好的。我尽量那个每一段话我不见得说完嘛，我分成两三段两三段的，这样跟你这边有一个翻译的时间嘛，你看这样好吗？
好呀好呀，可以
的。
嗯。然后翻页这边也是我来翻，就是这个 PPT 这边。
好的好的，中途有几张 PPT 呢？中途有几张 PPT， 可能是我们没有写文字，但是要请你提供，帮我们翻一下啊。
哦，就是中文的那个图片对吧？
对，可能我到时候我会给你有一个提示啊。
嗯，好呀好呀，没事啊，就是我翻您说的。
嗯，好的，嗯。
好，石头这边，时间也差不多，然后我们，我这边先做一个简单的英文的开场白，然后，剩下的时间就交给您这边来分享。好的。Hello everyone, welcome back. So, this is the second session of today's event. So, in this part, we are honored to invite a representative from the Chengdu high-tech zone to give you this introduction about their development demonstration. So, the speaker is Mr. Chen Jun, and he is responsible for this for the free trade zone development. And this development department is from the new economy bureau of this high-tech zone. And Mr. Chen Jun now is responsible for this, for the international network, international communication with all the countries around the world. And also he's responsible for a typical center, which is called the China-Europe Center in the high-tech zone, which is our have a lot of innovation and communication work with the countries in the Europe and also in other countries around the Belt and Road. So let's welcome Mr. Chen Jun to give this presentation about the high-tech zone and their international cooperation experience. 好，陈处，现在时间交给您，您可以开始了。好的，尊敬的各位领导、各位嘉宾、女士们、先生们。 非常荣幸能够借此机会向大家推介成都高新区的发展历程、创新资源以及招商引资的目前的情况。首先呢，想给大家介绍的就是现在我的这个背景图呢，是位于我们成都的欧洲中心。 这个欧洲中心呢，它是由成都市与欧盟委员会、国家商务部、国家科技部于2017年5月份共同启动的。它是主要建立在，主要是由我们成都作为内部城市打造的向欧开放的一个重要的桥头堡的一个门户窗户门户的平台，同时呢，它也是我们四川建设"一带一路"的一个战略交往中心。
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. And from Chengdu, it's really my pleasure to present you here about the history and development of Chengdu High Tech Zone. And I will highlight on the development of the high technology industry and also the innovation resource cultivation and also business and commercial activity and promotion in our high tech zone. So first of all, I just would like to point you out and the background of my slides. It's actually a snapshot of the Sichuan and Europe Center, which is co-built by the by EU and Ministry of Finance and Ministry of Science and Technology, PRC, in the year 2015. And the idea is to make Chengdu or Sichuan as the inline, as the gateway for the collaboration and connection with Europe from inland China. So, because you know, Sichuan is in the heart of China, of the mainland China. And also it is another major movement to have Sichuan actively participating in the Belt and Road Initiative.
为什么要介绍我背后这张图呢？因为非常值得庆幸的是哈，因为就在不久前的前天，4月20日，中共中央政治局常委、国务院总理李克强刚好就莅临了我背后的这种大楼。他在现场调研的时候指出，我们要以欧洲中心为起点，为基础平台，要发挥它更大的平台作用，同时呢。 要把这个欧洲中心打造成一个全球合作的中心，把成都这张名片插得更亮，打造西南国际消费中心、区域技术合作中心和商贸交流中心。这是我的开场白啊。
嗯 So actually, why I want you to focus on the background of my screen, because as I mentioned, it's the Europe Center in Chengdu. And actually on the 20th of this month, just yesterday or the day before yesterday, we had the honor to receive the current premier Li Keqiang to visit us and to visit the Europe Center and in the background. So actually, today I quote him. Premier Li Keqiang says that the Sichuan Europe Center should play its role as a platform to enhance international collaboration and to build Chengdu municipality into a gateway or into the hub for the public consumption in the northwest part of China, and also to become the hub for science and technology collaboration, and also to build a business center inland China.
好，谢谢。那么在推介成都高新区之前呢，请允许我简要的介绍一下成都市的基本情况。成都市它是四川省的省会城市，也是国家中心城市，幅员面积 14,300平方公里, 实际管理人口 2,120.8万人.
So before introducing the high-tech zone, I would like to give you an introduction about the basic idea about Chengdu municipality. It is the capital city of Sichuan province and also the heart of central China. And you can see this is the map of China, and here is the location of Chengdu, with the total area of 14,300 square kilometers and a total population of
2020年呢，成都市的GDP已经达到了1.77万亿元，在全国城市排名升至第七位。同时呢，成都拥有104个国际友好和友好合作城市，聚集了德法奥等国驻融领事机构20家，是中国欧盟投资贸易合作 洽谈会的永久会址。目前，落户成都的世界500强企业有305家，国别合作园区有6个。
And you can see actually this is the another more like detailed introduction to Chengdu municipality. In the year 2020, the GDP of the municipality reached 1.77 trillion RMB, ranking number 7 in China. And also we have here is a we have 20 consulates of different countries, Germany, France, Australia, and we have entered into we have 104 sister and brother cities worldwide. Chengdu has become the permanent host for China-ASEAN trading fair. And for top five Fortune 500 companies, we have their presence. We have 305 companies have their presence in Chengdu. And also for the international collaboration, featured park, altogether 6.
那么目前呢，成都已成为中国第三个拥有双国际机场的城市，开通国际航线129条，居中西部城市之首。2020年旅客吞吐量位居全国第二。
So let's talk about the transportation, the air transportation. And Chengdu is the third place in China, have 2 international airports, and with a total of 305, you can see the third city in China with 2 international airports, and Shuangliu International Airport and Tianfu International Airport, and international flights altogether 120 129, and also with the passenger throughput of 55.86 million, and cargo output 672,000 tons.
作为成都市改革开放领头羊和经济发展的主引擎，成都高新区呢，筹建于1988年，然后1991年获批全国首批国家级高新区，2006年被确定为全国创建世界一流高科技园区试点园区。 是四川省全面创新试验改革区和中国四川自由贸易试验区的核心区域。
So about the history of the science part of the high tech zone, the construction of the high tech zone is to build the local science and technology capability and to use this high tech zone to further stimulate local economy and contribute to the national level. And you know, the preparation of the high tech zone started in 1988. And it was proved as one of the first batch of national high-tech zones in China in 1991. And in 2006, it was approved as one of the first batch world top high-tech park pilot zone. And in 2012, one of the first batch of pilot zone for integration promotion of science and finance and national IP demonstration park. And also one of the first national independent innovation demonstration zone in the west part of China.
那么成都高新区呢，现有面积234.4平方公里，主要我们向下有5个功能园区，分别是电子信息产业功能区、天府国际生物城、新经济活力区、交子公园金融商务区。 和未来科技城五大产业功能区，加快建设世界一流高科技园区。
So we are moving towards a world-class high-tech park with the total area of 234.4 square kilometers. And the high-tech zone has 5 major functional areas focusing on different industries and sectors. For example, the integrated circuit and also Tianfu biomedicine or biology and the new economy activity zone and the Jiaozi Park of science and tech, financial innovation or financial service center. And also we have a future science park.
成都高新区经济发展活跃，2020年，我们统筹推进疫情防控和社会经济发展，全区地区生产总值达到2400亿元，以8.3%的经济增长率领跑全国。那么这个同比高出全省和全市，超出4个百分点。那么2020年，中保区实现 进出口总额5500亿元，连续34个月在全国近百个中保区保持第一。
The open economy. So in the year 2020, although we suffered from COVID, the epidemic, but we still managed to have the social recover on the social and economic development. The total industry added value in the year of 2020 was 240 billion RMB with a year-on-year growth rate of 8.34% higher than the provincial average and municipal average. And in terms of the export and import value in high-tech comprehensive bounded area, and it was 54.917 billion RMB. That is top in China, and that is also top among almost 100 bounded areas in China.
那么成都高新区企业聚集度非常的高，聚集了市场主体、 24万家，其中刚才已经介绍，世界500强企业130家，上市企业，43家，新三板挂牌企业127家，高新技术企业2700余家。
So we have also gathered a group of renowned and excellent companies or market players here in the high tech zone. For example, the total number of market entity is up to 240,000. And Fortune 500 companies, 130. Listed companies on the stock market, 43. And the companies listed on new OTC markets, 127, and high tech enterprises, 2,700.
具体而言呢，我们高新区，主要聚焦三个主导产业，那么分别是电子信息、生物医药和新经济。
So the three leading or major industries in the high tech zone are electronic information, biomedicine, and new economy.
那么下面呢，我将就这三个主导产业分别给大家做一个详细的介绍。首先第一个是电子信息产业，实力雄厚。2020年实现规上企业总产值3780亿元。占整个成都市比重的80%以上，同比增长14%。主要是发展集成电路、新型显示、智能终端及网络通讯。
So, first of all, I would like to introduce all of the three leading industries in the high tech zone. The first one is electronics information. So in the year 2020, we have altogether 138 enterprises about the designated size or skill, and their total, their gross output, industrial output was 378 billion RMB with a year-on-year growth of 14%, taking 80% or even higher of the Chengdu municipal city total. And so that means we have really a solid foundation for this industry, and we have very strong momentum and dynamism for the industry activities. To have a more like a detailed look about the electronic information and all these major segments include integrated circuits and new generation of display, smart terminals, and internet communication.
在集成电路方面，我们的产业链发展成熟完善，主要聚集了像英特尔、德州仪器等一批龙头企业。
So for integrated circuits, we have accumulated a very mature industrial chain that has attracted enterprises, renowned multinational companies like Intel and Texas Instruments.
那么在新型显示方面，我们作为全国重要的新型显示及中小尺寸面板生产基地，聚集了京东方、天马等一批头部企业，这些企业的业务不光是在国内，而且还远销到咱们海外，海外的占比也逐年的在提升。
So actually, let's have another look about the new and innovative display. This business also achieved a great performance. We have many renowned companies or leading companies in China, and also they have the global presence and their global share, and their global market share is increasing. For example, like BOE and New Way. And so this is, we have created an important manufacturing base of this type of display equipment or devices and small, medium-sized display panels.
那么在智能终端方面，我们重点布局可穿戴、车载电子、智能电视、工业互联网等产品线，吸引了富士康、戴尔、西门子等一批知名企业。
So smart terminal perspective, we focus on wearable devices, vehicle electronics, smart TV, and industrial Internet of Things. And companies like world leading companies, like including Foxconn, H&P, and Siemens.
在网络通讯方面，我们已建成国内第四大通信技术及设备研发中心，形成了从材料到网络到方案的全产业链。
And in terms of the network and communication perspective, we have become the number four in China with the, you know, so the number four is the skill of the IT and device R&D center. So we have made ourselves into a hub in southwestern China and created a four industrial chain covering material, internet, network, and related solutions.
以上是电子信息这个板块。那么在生物医药产业这个板块呢，我们2020年产业规模首次突破了600亿元，其中实现规上工业产值266亿元，增长10%。全国生物医药产业园区综合竞争力排名跃至第三，主要是以生物医药、生物医学工程、生物服务、健康新经济为主要发展方向，建有全国唯一的国家级新药专项成果转移转化试点示范基地。
So, let's have another look about the about the second leading industry or pillar industry in the high tech zone.Also with very strong foundation and performance, biomedicine. And in the year 2020, it is the first time in the history for the high-tech zone to achieve a industrial scale or output of 60 billion RMB or even higher in biomedicine, the specific sector.And the contributions or the industry, the gross industry outputof enterprises above the designated scale, that value was 26.6 billion RMB. And the industry output, the industry growth output has been increased by over 10%, ranking number three in China. And the highlighted services here or the capability and the, you know, the strength of the high tech zone in biomedicine.Are the new drug development, related R&D, and medical engineering, and related services, and healthcare, healthcare industry development. So, and also in the high-tech zone, we have built a new drug, transfer and transformation center. That is also the first in China.
那么当前呢，我们以天府国际生物城为核心载体，在生物医药产业方面，我们已经聚集了这个大家耳熟能详的赛诺菲、艾尔健，然后美敦力等企业，总共呢超过了2900余家，初步形成了现代中药、化学药、生物制剂、医疗器械等重点产业集群。
So here, still on the slides, you can see that we have created ourselves into a very strong base for the biomedicine industry, and relying on the platform of Tianhe International Bio City.We have a track created an industry cluster with the presence of renowned pharmaceuticals globally, for example, Sanofi and Medtronic. And in general, in the high tech zone, we have over 2,900 enterprises from the biomedicine industry.
好，现在我向大家介绍第三个板块，就是新经济产业这个板块。目前呢，我们已经，新经济，通俗的讲呢，就是新技术下驱动的新技术、新动能。 目前呢已经聚集了新经济性质的企业近九万家，平台生态型龙头企业三家，培育独角兽企业五家，邓林企业380家。那么2020年以新经济为代表的盈利性服务业企业实现营业收入1103亿元，同比增长 30.3%。
So this is about the new economy, another part of the strength of the high tech zone. And for a new economy branch, so here we mainly utilize the emerging technology to drive the development, to drive the high quality development to drive the high quality development. So in this perspective, we have 90,000 enterprises from the new economy activities, and including three leading enterprises nationwide from the national perspective, and five unicorn companies and 380 gazelle companies. So in the year 2020, the total output was 110.3 billion RMB with a growth rate of more than 30%.
好，那么下面我们所在的新经济，这下面大家看到的一张示意图，就是我们高新南区新经济活力区的区域位置。那么这个地方呢，2020年，它一共有80多平方公里哈，但是它实现了产业增加值达到了1716.3亿元，以全市0.56%的土地贡献了全市9.7%的产业增加值，那么人均 GDP 达到了15.6万元，那么地均 GDP 达到了21.6亿元每平方公里。
So let's have this very detailed introduction about the new economy zone within the high tech zone. So we can call it new economy area, functional area. So this is the map.Here you can see all these detailed figures and the performance of the new economy area. And in the year actually, the new economy area actually takes 80 square kilometers, but with an output, industrial output of 176.3 billion. So it takes only 0.56% of the total land of the city of the Chengdu municipality, but contribute to 9.7% growth in the industrial output. So to have a per capita analysis, the output per capita was 156,000 RMB, and the output per square meters was 2.16 billion RMB.
那么在这样一个区域里面呢，我们又向下布局了诸多个产业社区。正如图上所示，我们布局了新川创新科技园、邓林谷产业社区、祁隆湾产业社区、AI 创新中心、中国欧洲中心和天府软件园六大产业社区。那么聚焦的产业门类呢，主要是指5G 与人工智能、网络视听与数字文创、大数据与网络安全等新经济产业。
So you can see all this. So we have really a very detailed and well organized the structure for the new economy area, and it can be further divided into six sub areas.Including one Gazelle Valley, and that is the space for a company for gazelles, and one Qinglong Wan Park, and AI Artificial Intelligence Innovation Hub, and China Europe Center, as I already introduced you previously, And one Singapore's Sichuan High Tech Innovation Park and the Tianfu Software Park. So within this well-developed new economy area, we're mainly focusing on the emerging technologies, and by utilizing the fifth generation of the network, and to cultivate this kind of new business model, new businesses, or creative business like audio and video content creation, culture and creativity, and big data, cybersecurity. So all type of this high technology or technology intensive segments.
下面呢，我再简要把这三大产业社区里面的这几个产业细分领域板块做一个简单的介绍。 第一个呢是我们的5G通讯和人工智能，目前呢聚集了这个人工智能的企业100余家，那么年营业收入呢是达到了45亿元，同时聚集了100余家的 5G 通信企业，年营业收入呢是达到了130亿元。
So here you can see this is a more like detailed introduction to different segment, different businesses or different sectors of the from the new economy, from the new economy zone. And the first I would like to point you out is the generation communication technology and artificial intelligence. So literally focused on the fifth generation and network. The overview, artificial intelligence companies with a total number of over 100. So there might be some error on the slides. So that is 100 AI companies with a total output and annual income or revenue up to 4.5 billion RMB. And the fifth generation and the 5G enterprises also over 100 with a annual revenue of 13 billion RMB.
在第二个板块呢，就是在网络视听和数字文创方面。 我们这个产业社区是全国的首批国家级文化和科技融合示范基地，也是全国首个国家网络游戏动漫产业发展基地，同时还是全国第二个国家动漫游戏产业振兴基地。那么现在聚焦的数字文创企业，超过了600余家。那么在2019年呢，这个文创产业增加值是196.8亿元，同比增长51.4%。
So again, about another sector of the new economy area, network, audio and visual, and digital culture and creativity. So the high-tech zone is one of the first batch of national demonstration base for cultural and technical culture and technology integration, and also one of the first national development base for online gaming and animation, and also the second national base for revitalizing the game, the online gaming and animation. So currently speaking, enterprises from this perspective, from digital cultural production and creative production up to over 600, with a value added output of 19.68 billion RMB, and also enjoying a year-on-year growth of 51.4%.
那么在大数据和网络安全这个板块呢，我们现在聚集了大数据企业90余家，实现的营业收入是达到了156亿元，占整个成都市的40%。在网络安全方面的企业超过了200家，实现总营业收入128亿元，占整个成都市的50%。
So big data and network security sector, overview of the development, and big data enterprises over 90, and total revenue up to 15.6 billion, and with a taking 40% of the Chengdu total. And cybersecurity wise, 200 plus enterprises in this field, with a total revenue of 120 28 billion RMB, and 50% of the city of the total of the Chengdu city.
下一张呢，就是刚才在最开始给大家介绍的欧洲中心，大家可以看到图片上这个有李克强总理亲临欧洲中心，检阅我们前期的工作成效。那么这栋大楼呢，我们是着力打造成国际的服务中心和新兴的商贸中心，以及“一带一路”的交往中心。
This is the China Europe Center I've introduced you already, and on the snapshot you can see we're receiving Premier Li Keqiang. During the visit, we introduced him about the achievements and the development of the China Europe Center, and you can see this is a very beautiful building. And the aim of the platform China Europe Center is to build itself into a service platform for international cooperation, and also build itself into a business and a commerce center, and also a communication hub for the Belt and between China and the Belt and Road countries.
整栋大楼的建筑面积呢是 21万平方米， 目前的入住率是 42%， 那么聚集了这个主要以欧洲国家还有一带一路沿线国家的机构企业一共170个， 其中重点的项目有34个。
So the total construction area of the building of the China Europe Center is up to 210,000 meters squares. And currently speaking, 42% of the space has been taken already by different enterprises and organizations from Europe and Belt and Road regions and countries. So currently speaking, we have now 170 partners in that they have already settled down physically in this building in the China EU Center, and carrying 34 major projects.
所以呢，正如刚才所说哈，现在目前入住率是 42%， 我们还有 60% 的空间，我们也非常的愿意以这栋大楼作为支撑点，作为载体，和我们今天与会的 世界各国的科技园区建立这种海外园区或者是姊妹园区这样的一种绑定关系，这个是第一层。第二层意思呢，我们也非常的欢迎，在今天参会的咱们的各类的机构啊、企业，甚至一些学术代表啊这些哈，在欧洲中心设立这个你们海外的办事处，我们会给予
So the reason why I just introduced you about this 40% has been taken, but we still have 60% or 6% opportunity open to all of you and to you, my dear friends online today. And we want to build the China Europe Center into a platform for the international collaboration and for the science and technology exchange. So I maybe here propose invite you to have further discussion and to maybe potentially join us in the China EU Center. For example, by creating some collaboration to building up to creating some collaboration in park construction, or in the other way, because I know you are from government organizations, enterprises, or some from academy, maybe you can set up your China office here, and we will definitely provide you the best preferential policies as we can.
谢谢。 那么这是欧洲中心，下一个板块呢，想向大家介绍高新区的另外一个功能区，就是交子公园金融商务区。那么这个区域目前聚集了金融及配套机构2000余家，金融领域10万余人的人才在这里面，主要招引这个金融总部、金融科技、高端零售等业态。 旨在打造成都的创新金融城、时尚活力区、公园新商圈和潮流目的地。
So actually, this is another functional area of the high-tech zone called Financial Business District of Jiaozi Park. You can maybe just call it CBD area. So it is the financial headquarter. So it aims to attract financial headquarters for like financial institutions and to settle down here, or it's another main focus of the area is to build the high-end retailing services or high-end retailing businesses. So the area, currently speaking, has attracted over 2,000 companies and with over 100,000 of the population or talents working here and living here. So the position of the positioning of this CBD area of Jiaozi Park is to become an innovation city of finance for financial services and instruments, and to become the fashion zone or like an utility zone, and also to become the new park, to become the new business area, and also to attract, and also is the destination of all type of new business movements and trends.
最后一个功能区呢是未来科技城，这是我们在成都的东部新区布局的60平方公里的一块区域，那么也是我们旨在打造应用型科学中心、智能示范区还有国际科教城这样的一些业态领域。那目前呢已经有阿里云西部云计算中心、民航飞行学院、天府校区和三峡集团的这个能源投资总部等项目陆续入驻，总投资超过了1000亿元。
So, this is the future science city of the high tech zone, and you can see on the slides with a total area of 60 square meters, and it focuses on the application science and technology. And also to cultivate the science and technology and education services here. Currently speaking, we have attracted many renowned partners here. For example, we have Alibaba Cloud to set up its Western headquarters in this science park, in this tech city. And also we have created a civil aviation training platform. And also we have some collaboration with the Three Gorge group. And currently speaking, the area has attracted an investment of altogether 100 billion RMB.
好，以上呢是整个高新区的产业功能区的介绍。接下来呢，我再简要的给各位介绍一下我们这边的金融政策相关方面的一些内容。第一个是我们这边高新区金融服务便捷完善，目前呢已经聚集了各类金融机构1300余家，那么拥有呢股权投资机构660余家，构建了科技型中小企业全生命周期的融资路线图。那么近年来我们吸引了上交所、深交所、西部基地落户，累计培育上市公司42家，帮助区内的企业获得风投200亿元以上。
So this is the previous I just introduced you the functional area for industry development. Next, I would like to give you an example about the financial services here in the high tech zone. So we are trying to create the financial services are trying to create convenience and facilitation to investors and also to those enterprises who develop their business here for different type of commercial activities. Currently speaking, there are over 66 investment and management institutions here. And also we have the collaboration with the Shanghai Stock Exchange and Shenzhen Stock Exchange to set up their West branches in our high tech zone. And by far we have 42 companies went public successfully. And the venture capital we helped to organize with a total value of 20 billion or even higher.
这是金融机构金融体系方面。此外，我们还拥成都高新区还拥有完备的科技型企业全生命周期培育体系与政策。下一。So
besides that,
下一，不好意思，下一。还是下一页。对，下一。Okay. Besides
the financial services and supports, we have created a complete set of policy system to cover the life cycle of enterprises in the high-tech zone.
那么这些企业, 我们可以考虑从小微企业到, 初创, 到邓林, 到准独角兽, 到独角兽, 以及到平台型, 生态龙头企业。 每一个企业的不同的发展阶段，我们都有与之相匹配的设计到，招引政策、产业培育政策、人才激励政策和科技创新政策与产业服务政策与之相紧密的配合。目前兑现了产业政策已经超过了3000家企业。
So this is the well-off policy system to support, as I mentioned, about enterprises at different stages. For example, like small and medium enterprises or even below that scale can achieve some support, policy support from our side. And also our policy support and also gave the opportunity to, you know, startup companies or gazelle companies and pre-unicorn company or even industry leaders. So we have the mature and ready available policies to everyone in this science park, in our high tech park, in our high tech zone. So we match different policies or different industry services to them. Currently speaking, they can enjoy like consultancy services or industry services or science technology related fostering services. So currently speaking, altogether over 3,000 enterprises has received our policy support.
去年2020年，我们就兑现了各类政策资金7485万元，支持了299家种子雏鹰企业，180家邓林企业，3家潜在独角兽和独角兽企业，以及2家平台生态型龙头企业。
So actually last year we have organized a very large scale of financial support to enterprises in the high tech zone of altogether 728.4 billion RMB, covering 299 startups, 180 gazelle companies and 3 unicorn companies and 2 industrial leaders.
那么以上呢就是我对整个高新区发展历程。 科技创新资源以及招商引资的一个简要汇报，可能当中还有很多不尽详尽的地方。那么我希望下来以后呢，能够和各位科技园区的朋友再进行深度的洽谈。那么同时呢，也真诚的希望广大的这个科技园区的朋友、国际友人和各界人士能够亲自莅临成都高新区交流、工作、生活、成就梦想。 那么我们将以一流的理念、一流的服务和一流的环境努力提供全面的保障和支持，和大家一起共创美好的未来。谢谢大家。So
that is my introduction about the high tech zone, and thank you for your listening. And due to limited time, I cannot give you a very detailed introduction. So if you have more to ask or more interest, you can just contact me later on after the session. And this is the brief introduction. So sincerely, I hope I encourage your visit to our high tech zone after the epidemic, and you can have we have formulated a very mature and sound environment for science and technology innovation, and also for like a high tech industry cultivation, and I hope this high tech zone should be a place to take off. Should be a place to have your dream come true, and should be a place to provide you support in both of the policy, service, and business environment or science and technology environment. And thank you very much, and looking forward to your questions and contact.
Thank you very much for your presentation. My name is Ali from Azerbaijan. You mentioned that you have six international parks. Are these including that you said China, Europe Center or something else is about that international park?
那么，陈处在里面，您介绍了就是有六个国别园区。那么其中，我想问一下，就是更加具体的一些信息。它是否包含您提到的这个欧洲中心？那么如果不包括的话，那么可否就是大概跟他们讲一下这个六个国别园区是什么？主要几个国别园区哈，我们有这个。 中法的国别园区是在我们的另外一个区，是在天府新区，还有中法的园区是在另外一个区，还有中义的一个科技园区，还有中德的一个科技园区，以及中日的一个合作发展园区，以及这个成都和新加坡的一个发展园区。那么这些发展园区。 他们的一些这里面涉及到的有一些企业，或者一些机构，和我们欧洲中心，就是您看到的背后这栋大楼，我们都有一些业务上的一些往来和合作。那么具体呢，他们是以机构的形式在存在。Just
give you the direct answer about this kind of international park. And also the relationship with the China Europe Center. China Europe Center is not one from the six. So for the international park, so it is like a bilateral collaboration between China and the foreign countries. For example, we have a China France park, which is not located here in, the physical space. It is located in another district. And also the China Italy Park and China Germany Park and China Japan Park and also a Chengdu Singapore Park. So for these international parks, they do have, even though they are separate entities, but those international parks do have close collaboration with the China Europe Center. So institutions and enterprises from those entities can collaborate and can interact or have their cooperation. So this is like all these business entities, they collaborate.
Thank you very much, sir.
非常感谢您的解答。
Thank you.
Okay, guys, any other questions for Mr. Chen about this China-European Center or other or any other topics? So if you don't have any more questions, I think it's okay for today. And after the session today, I'll also ask Mr. Chen to give me the business card and I will send you all the context about this hashtag Zoom and also the hashtag Zoom, the previous one, hashtag Zoom. So, so today, before leaving, let's thank you, Mr. Chen, for his brilliant presentation. And please, as usual, open up your videos. We can take this group photos. 陈助理好，现在我刚才跟他们介绍的是，他们现在没有什么问题，那我稍后的话呢，我请那个夏老师把您的这个名片发给我，然后会后他们如果有什么问题，会通过邮件的方式跟您联络。然后今天现在就是最后一个议程呢，是我们大家都把摄像头打开，然后我们这边来截个屏，就通过这种方式让您跟这个所有的学员来进行一个合影。好的，
好的，谢谢。
Okay, everybody, so please open up all your videos and we can take this group photo.
陈阳，你先把你的分享关掉好。嗯，好的。你帮我切断吧，我好像。我现在有不分享了吗？
Okay, guys, please all open up your videos. You can take this photo. Okay, just a minute. Okay, just a minute. Okay, 1, 2, 3, open up. Okay. Okay, and 1, 2, 3. Okay, guys, let's say thanks and goodbye to Mr. Chen. And he's looking forward to your contacts after the session.
Thank
you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.